Hi, I'm Lisa Dixon and welcome to Divorce TV. Today we're going to talk about writing the best affidavit you can. And I usually say a kick-ass affidavit. Pardon my French, but that's what you want. Welcome back to my channel, and if this is your first time, I'm Lisa Dixon and I'm your divorce expert. Don't forget to hit subscribe and hit the bell button so you get free divorce expert advice like child custody, child alimony, and financial settlements. Now let's get straight into it. So if you've never done an affidavit or you haven't had to do a deposition, this is a beginner's guide. So this is when you're going to court and you basically have to make a statement of facts. But what it is it's your side, it's your story as you see it, as you see the facts. And that's one of the most important things that people forget, especially if other people are trying to help you to write it, is the number one tip I have for you is that this is your story, this is your life, this is what's gone on in your divorce, in your marriage. So therefore, you have to write it as if it is a story. Now, it is facts, but you also have to think about what has happened. And you have to set the scene, and nobody else will know the background except for you. So you have to make sure that you have the background in. Now, of course, this is one of the many affidavits that I have had, and they can be much bigger than this. This is only a couple of inches. I'm not saying that yours has to be this thick, but what I'm saying is if it's used in court, it's an affidavit and it's a statement of facts. But remember, it's a statement of how you see it and you're going to set the scene. So let me share with you an example. I had a client, she had very young children. There was a lot of violence in the relationship. Now, it's really important that she set the scene and she didn't let a lot of other people try and take over and diminish the importance of things like that that had happened. And it can be exactly the same where I had a client where a lot of money was stolen, where a lot of properties were taken away, and also in cases where there may be a business and one of you gets pushed out of the business. So these are all really important factors to take into account in your story. So that's the number one tip to remember is yes, it's a statement of facts. Yes, it's for the court. Yes, it has to be factual. But at the end of the day, you have to tell a story and it's your story. Number two is keep your story, and because it's your story, you will be able to keep it consistent. You may unfortunately end up being in court for a long, long time, and I truly hope you're not, but if you are, your story, your statement of facts, because it's all based on what's happened to you, these are things that will be consistent. So it's always good to remember that all those things that you've put in, if you've had to do an affidavit for the very first time or you have to give a deposition, that you know your story and you keep it consistent. Number three is you must be able to back up your facts. You must be able to back up your statement. Remember, I gave you the example of the woman with the two younger children. So she did have a lot of AVO, police records, police statements, things that could be subpoenaed, things that could be used as factual backup for what she was saying. Now that's where it could be anything from bank statements, through to credit cards, through to receipts, through to photographs, family albums, anything like that, are all factual documentation. They're all evidence that you can use. And number four of your affidavit is you must always end with a really strong conclusion. So you know we talked about the beginning, we talked about that you must set the scene, you must give some background if there's been a lot of violence, if there's been a lot of stealing, whatever that's happened throughout your marriage, your divorce, you have to set that scene. It's the same with the conclusion. The conclusion should be strong, it should be sharp, and it should be to the point. So I hope these tips have really helped you today. It's really difficult when you are called in front of court, and I just wanted to try and clarify for you some of the tips that you will need when you write your affidavit or give your deposition. Thanks, it's nice to talk to you again. Thank you for sharing, liking, thank you for subscribing, and I'll see you on the next video. I'm Lisa Dixon from Divorce TV.